So I'm on the SunSynk stand here at the Smarter E in Munich. And the good thing about SunSynk is they bounce off the walls at funny angles. So a chance meeting on the stand can help answer a question that a lot of viewers have. And we've got Lawrence here from IONOS to help us out. Now, if you don't know IONOS, you might have seen adverts with a woman with an ice cream haircut who can help you with your internet service hosting and website things.
Yes.
But you're from a different side of IONOS.
I'm from the B2B, business-to-business avenue of IONOS, so yeah. IONOS Cloud.
What's your relationship with SunSynk?
Don't know them. No, I kid. No, SunSynk are the leading battery and inverter supplier globally. They came to IONOS because they said, look, we want to enter into certain markets where compliance is important, data integrity is important, things like GDPR. They were also very aware about cybersecurity as well when coming into the West, let's say. Mm-hmm. Keith and Joel came with a list, and I said, we could do some of those, and some of them we've got to be a bit innovative together to achieve them. And yeah.
So just to unpack that a little bit, obviously a lot of SunSynk products connect to the internet, and you've got an app which obviously puts your phone into the system, puts your home IT infrastructure into the system, your Wi-Fi network. And I believe that if you're operating in a certain geography, particularly Europe, you have to hold all of that data in Europe. Is that right?
So the legislation is that data preferably generated in Europe should remain in Europe. And the nuance is preferably should stay in Europe. There are other CSPs that are not European CSPs, and utilizing those CSPs, you can't guarantee where the data is. In actuality, they'll tell you the data goes across the world and then back to their data center that's located in Europe. For IONOS, we keep all of your data within Europe. We guarantee GDPR, General Data Protection Regulations. We also give you guaranteed data sovereignty. That again is the very key part, making sure that your data stays local. It's important that when you create data, because as we said, all these IoT edge devices are creating lots and lots of data, and you kind of want to know who else has access to my data, right? GDPR says that only IONOS and yourself, or SunSynk in this case, should be the controller of your data. Even if a law enforcement agency wanted to come to us and access SunSynk's customer data, we say no, because we're a European business. In Europe, it says GDPR is very specific that actually the controller and the actor of the data are the arbiters, not us, the CSP. So actually we wouldn't give anyone's data anywhere. Slightly different to other companies who have to abide by the US Cloud Act. I'm not going to go into that, but research the US Cloud Act. That will give you a little bit of insight about which cloud service providers behave in a certain way and which ones behave in a different way. It's just legislation.
For viewers, it's always a big thing people worry about. Data security, particularly in markets like Germany or Switzerland, where they normally think
the two most data intense markets are Germany, DE, and Switzerland as well. And IONOS is actually a German company. IONOS recently was awarded the ITZ Bund contract with the German government, who made some choice decisions to no longer work with some of the American cousin CSPs that you might have heard of. This is the German government, are focusing to deliver that through IONOS Cloud. So that gives you a little bit of information about what a government who are very data intense and very data aware have decided to use IONOS Cloud. So SunSynk are in good hands.
Okay, so I'm looking at my SunSynk app, you know, I'm checking my energy data and things like that. Where physically in Europe is that data actually sitting?
The data sits across various different geographies within Europe. It sits in 5 different locations in Germany, 2 different locations in the UK. I believe it's 2 or 3 locations in Paris. And I'm saying locations because we don't want to tell you exactly where they are, because we don't really want you to turn up at the data centers. We also have locations in Spain, Logroño, big part of Spain.
Very interesting. Be interesting to get any viewers' comments about things like data security and things you're worried about, because perhaps we could delve a little bit deeper to that in a future video. And of course, we're here in Munich. And for once, as Keith would say, it is not raining.
It's not raining!
It isn't raining.